Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. In today's video, we are going to demonstrate and know the working of the power and harmonic analyzer from Tesca. This is also known as three-phase power quality analyzer. So this is basically used for the measurement of quality of a three-phase power system or a single-phase power system or different wire systems. So this basically uses with different combinations, and this gives very detailed information about all the power systems qualities and disqualities. Also, it can able to measure the proper harmonics which are present in the any power system. So we will move on to the descriptions of this. So this is our basic kit for three-phase power quality analyzer. The order code for this kit is 17716C. So you can purchase this kit from this order code while visit our official website, which is www.tesca.in. So now we will start with this basic kit. So this is a basic kit or the instrument which is used to measurement the power quality. So this also comes with different accessories. So this is the power adapter to give the power of this instrument. These are the current probes for all the different phases as required, which is used as requirement in the three phase, single phase or any other multi-phase systems. These are the voltage probes which are connected to this kit or instrument. These are also alligator's clip, so one can easily connect high voltage wires to measure the power and harmonics present in them and to analyze the quality of that power. This also comes with the user manual and user guide for the instrument and the software as well. Software manual also provided with this kit, and this is the software CD to communicate the function of the all instrument, which are readings which are provided with this instrument. And this is the cable to communicate this instrument with the PC interface, and this is the extra set of batteries if required when there is no power available. This can also works on the battery power. And this is the accessories and kit bag which is also provided to place the all items from this important and fragile kit or the fragile instrument in the powerful and rugged bag with this kit. So now we will start with power on this kit. For power on this kit, we will use this 12 volt AC or DC adapter which can easily connected in any. So for power on this instrument, we will first connect this power adapter to the AC power source, which is a 230 volt AC power source, and this connector will be connected to this power connector which is right down at this kit, you can see here. And this kit also comes with this steady stand which will be easy to place this kit and to work on this instrument. So we will stand this kit with this stand, and now this is the first power on button for this kit. So as I press this button, the power of this instrument has started. So there are different buttons which are placed on this kit. So I will explain you the different buttons which how the works. So this is the basic setup button to set up the functions of this different values. So we can select which function we want to set up. So there are different many functions including the year, month, date, hour, minutes, seconds. It will give all the details, and we will download this file through the software. So these are the setup, and the setup can be changed with this blue arrows which are the right left arrows. So this is the frequency selector, you can see here. I can change the frequency with this buttons by up, down and right and left arrows. And while pressing the setup button again, you can change the value which is to be changed. So this is how the setup screen works. Now if you want to exit from this setup screen, you can press exit and this will show the basic readings which will be taken. So right now we are not connected any system, so this is showing no readings. So this is the transient response. So as we press this transient response, all the readings properly which are at which the system is connected will be given. And this is the magnitude button which will give the harmonics of the system when we press this. So this will give the harmonics graphs and the harmonics value. Now this is the hold button or to read button. So this will be hold the setup while working with this. So this is the transient response and this is the magnitude of harmonics. Now while measuring the power, we will press this power button. So we will come to the power screen at which we will see the all the power details. And this is the button to change the system type, which is R2 measured. So this will give the single phase, three phase, one wire, two wire, three wire or four wire system. And this button will show the voltage and current currents waveforms at this, which will also give actual voltage and waveforms and the values also. This will give only voltage and this will give voltage and current, which will be included as the phase diagram. So phase diagram also provided with this instrument. So this instrument can also give you phase diagram with this phase button. So as you press this phase button, you will get the phasor diagram of accurate what we are going to this test system. This is the backlight button to on and off the backlight of this screen, LCD screen. And this is the power button, on off button, which I have already described. And this is the range selector button for voltage and current. So all the different ranges can be selected from this button. So now we move on to first and demonstrate how the power will be and the power quality and the harmonics are analyzed with this instrument. So we will do the setup for this. So before setting up the arrangement to measuring and the quality of a system or a three phase or single phase power system, I will explain you the different components which are required to connect with this power supply, any of the power supply which is connected with this. So we required a current probe with this. So this is a current probe. This is the clamp system, which is the trigger of this current probe. And this is the range selector from 1 ampere, 10 ampere and 100 ampere. So this current probe can easily connected up to 100 amperes power supply. So this is the current probe with this DIN connector. So this connector can easily be connected with this instrument. And this is the current section. At this the current will be connected. This is the I1, I2 and I3. When working with the three phase, you can connect all the three probes of current at this I1, I2 and I3. These are the voltage connections, voltage connector V1, V2, V3 and also the neutral. While working with the three phase, four wire system or single phase, any of the voltage selection will be connected. So this is the voltage probes. So these are with the covers provided. You can open these covers from the connection end and also the probe end. This is the cover. And we are also providing crocodile connectors, which will be easily probe will be easily inserted in this. And these connectors can easily clamp any of the single conductor or live conductor to measure the voltages. So these are three probes, four probes here, R, Y, B, and for the neutrals there are four probes which I already discussed earlier in the demo. Now we will connect this current and voltage probes and measure the power quality of a single phase power system right now. So now we will test the power quality of a single phase system. We will use this bulb load which is provided here. So we use two probes for single phase. We know the neutral and phase, there are only two wire system. So for this we will connect this red wire to this voltage V1 terminal, which is the phase, and this black wire at this neutral terminal. Now we will connect this current probe with this dendrite connector to this I1 section. Properly match the connector and carefully press the connector so the pins do not bend. So I will show you the current probe. There are, if I am connecting the 40 watts around load, so the ampere range will be at 1 ampere. If I connecting the higher load, the ampere should be more than 1 or 10 or 100. So this is our current probe. Now we will connect the single phase supply. For this we have parallelly connect the wires to connect this crocodile clips to the two single phase two wire system. So these are the phase and neutral wire which have connected. So now we will connect this wire which is connected with the red probe to the phase, and the wire which is connected to the black probe will be connected to the neutral. So we will connect these wires. So I will connect this wire to the phase, and this one which is connected with the black one will be connected with the neutrals. So you can see the bulb has been started. So bulb has been started glowing, and we can see at this meter that power voltage is showing, which is 230 volts. Now for current measurement, we will connect this probe as the phase, in the phase direction. So phase is going through this red probe to the load. So we will connect this probe in the direction of the phase flow, current flow. So we can see the current also now showing at this meter, which is 173 milliamps around. Now we can also measure at this meter that the load is showing around 40.3 volts as we connected the 40 volts bulb here, and the power factor is around 1 or 0.98 in the efficiency is 1, and the power factor is 0.99 as we connected the resistive load, which is the pure resistive load, which also we are showing here that the apparent power, which is 40.2 volt amperes, and the reactive power is 0 as the load is purely resistive. So if we connected any motor load from single phase, we will find also get the reactive power here. So these are the watt hour consumption. So these are the watt hour consumption also showing at this screen. You can see this is the watt hour. So this is the 0.8 watt hour which is consumed by this bulb right now till we started this, and this is the hertz, which is 50 hertz frequency, and also showing the single phase two wire system at this section. And this is the volt ampere hour also, and the apparent power, and these are the different all the parameters which is shown, and the power quality will be measured with this. So now we move on to the transient response. This is the transient response. Now we will get the harmonics. So these are the harmonics value, harmonics level also showing at this meter. This is the amplitude of harmonics which are present in this system. also showing, and now we will again go back to the power mode. So this is the power. Now we will show the voltage and current waveforms. These are the voltage and current waveforms. This is the voltage at this moment. The upper waveform is of the voltage, also showing V with this, and this is the I waveform, which is the current's waveform. From this button we will only have to see this voltage waveforms. So the voltage level is 232.2 volts, frequency is 50 hertz. Now we will see the phase diagram. So this is the phase diagram of I current with reference of voltage. So that's how we measure the all parameters of this single phase system. Now we can also measure and record this data with this record button. So as I press the record button, you can see the recording has been started here. So this data has been recorded 9th time, and again I press the record, this recording is off, and again I record this data. The data value has been recorded at this. So this is the 10th recording of this, and this can be easily downloaded to the any PC or the communication software with the communication cable. So software is also provided with this kit. Now we will exit this system. So after measurement all the values, we can turn off this power supply. So power supply has been turned off. Now all the values has been cleared from here, and after using the instrument we will switch off this instrument like this. So that was the basic demonstration of this instrument. You can also use this instrument to the three phase power supply also. So all the kits and the instrument with this, or the components with this kit, are made from the insulated material properly, and the Cat 3 insulated material, and can be easily used to up to 1000 volts. Or if you want any of the detail while working with this, you can easily refer to the manual which is provided with this kit or with this instrument. Or for software, we will also providing a software manual which will help you to diagnose and record and summarize all the value from the system and working with this software. And anytime you find difficulty while working with this kit, you can easily contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.